CICU devices.
Fiber optic pressure sensors for medical use. The Fabry-Pérot sensor. Fiber optic sensors have become increasingly important in medical applications due to their unique properties and advantages. These sensors employ optical fibers to detect and measure various physiological parameters, offering significant benefits over traditional electronic sensors. At first, the only available method for continuously monitoring pressure in the circulatory system was the fluid-filled catheter method. This method has several disadvantages, such as poor dynamic response causing damping or overshooting, movement artifacts, or the potential for obstruction. The key advantages of the fiber optic sensors are as follows. Small size and flexibility. Fiber optic sensors are thin, lightweight, and flexible, allowing for minimally invasive procedures and integration into small medical devices. Electromagnetic interference immunity, as they are immune to electromagnetic interference, making them safe for use during MRI, radio frequency procedures, or electrocautery. Biocompatibility, as optical fibers can be sterilized using standard medical techniques and are chemically inert and non-toxic. And finally, good dynamic response, minimizing the dumping or overshooting effects. Currently, this technology is used in multiple cardiovascular devices, for example, in the intraaortic balloon pump, in the transaortic microaxial pumps like Impella or Supira device, in the fractional flow reserve measurement, or in the IKOR device, a coronary microcatheter to measure coronary pressure and flow. The most commonly used optical fiber sensors in cardiovascular devices employ the Fabry-Pérot interferometer technology. In this system, a light beam is generated in the console and travels through the optical fiber to the sensor. The Fabry-Pérot interferometer cavity is formed by two parallel surfaces that reflect light. The proximal surface generates a partial reflection, while the distal surface generates a full reflection. When the light beam reaches the first layer, a certain percentage is reflected back to the photodetector, while the remaining light continues traveling a distance, L, before being fully reflected at the membrane level. As a result, the second light beam travels a greater distance than the first beam, covering twice the distance, L. Thus, the second light beam reaches the photodetector with a certain delay due to the longer path it travels. When positive pressure is applied to the membrane, it deforms, causing the reflection of the second beam to occur more proximal. This means the beam travels a shorter distance and reaches the photodetector with less delay. These changes in distance and time can be analyzed using an algorithm to precisely estimate the pressure applied to the membrane. The complete system setup would be as follows. A light source in the console emits the light beam. The beam travels along the optical fiber until it reaches the Fabry-Pérot cavity. In the sensor, the previously described effect occurs. After that, the two light beams return along the optical fiber until they reach the console again. An optical coupler directs the light beams to the photodetector, where the signal is received. The console processes the signal, determining the phase difference between the light beams. This process is repeated at a frequency of 200 times per second, or in other words, at a frequency of 200 Hz. Finally, using an algorithm, it translates the information into a pressure curve displayed on the screen. We invite you to learn more about this topic as applied to the intra-aortic balloon pump and the Impella device in the following videos. The link can be found in the description.
If you've enjoyed our video, please press the like button and subscribe to support us so we can continue creating quality content like this.